Hello and welcome to Bits Play Games. In this video, I'm going to react to the September 14th, 2023 Nintendo Direct. Hopefully some of the stuff I listed in my earlier post is announced today. And I'm hoping for some Donkey Kong, F-Zero, any good GameCube remaster would excite me. So let's see what we get. Probably some predictable stuff, but I hope they throw some surprises in there. Let's check it out. All right, let's go. I kind of saw little inklings of there being rumors of a Nintendo Direct, but I mostly kind of ignored them. And it kind of just makes it more exciting when it finally gets here. Okay, it looks like it's finally going to show us a little bit of the new Splatoon 3 story DLC. It's pretty vague from the last stuff we saw. Kind of still has that, like, cryptic, like, weird vibe from the last trailer, but at least we're getting some more gameplay. Okay. Where's the color at? Looks interesting. I mean, it's Splatoon story DLC, so, I mean, I like the story, the last two, like, little campaign modes in Splatoon 2 and 3, and then the DLC for 2. So hopefully this is pretty good. Got some kind of green octoling. Yeah, I guess that makes sense. Okay. Okay, looks like there's some challenges. And the challenges unlock different stat bonuses, it looks like. That's cool. I always like the idea of, like, doing certain challenges and then getting little stat perks from it. Oh, what was that last thing? It looked like some kind of holographic armor. Is it gonna give us a release date? Side order? Are we getting a release date? Not yet!
Hello everyone, I'm Shinya Takahashi, and I'll be your guide for today's Nintendo Direct. You just saw a new trailer for Wave 2 of the Splatoon 3 Expansion Pass DLC,
that is correct.
Side Order.
Give us a date.
This brand new story is set in the Spire of Order, where you will strengthen your character's abilities as you ascend the Spire's floors.
Yeah, I like that.
This single player DLC so it can
like
be
a,
played over
like a tower
over
challenge
again.
Kind of thing.
It's planned to release in spring 2024.
Okay.
So please look forward to it.
Well, at least we have a general timeline for it.
Let's see our first batch of Nintendo Switch headlines.
Ooh.
The toys are back in town.
Okay, I never really played this series
Mario.
Too much, but
the rivalry that heated up on the
from
Game
what
Boy
I played, it was pretty fun.
On the Nintendo
so
Switch
I'm not
system.
Mad. It's not a surprise. It definitely seems prize. Like something they'd release at the
Donkey
end of the
Kong
Switch life cycle.
The mini Mario toys from the factory. And it's up to Mario.
I just hope it's
to
decent at least.
Down.
This version.
In each
graphics
stage,
are simple,
kind of
what you'd expect for this game.
Observation and action are vital to
I wonder
your
if we're
success.
Gonna add like a online
Mario
multiplayer
needs to reach the key, but he
option.
Can't quite cross the gap. That monkey's tail looks a little suspicious though.
So it's basically like a puzzle
if
game.
Mario does this. Now he can get across.
Whoa.
And safely grab the key. Platform too high? Reach it with a handstand jump or a backflip.
That's like crazy.
That. Observe and act to collect.
Yeah, this
Mario.
Is one of those things where it's like
stages and face Donkey Kong.
Obviously. Didn't know this was coming, but it makes sense for
updated version of the game, you can play
a game we're gonna do for the holiday.
However you choose to puzzle your way through,
I think he said local co-op, I'm not sure, I didn't think I heard online.
Mario vs. Donkey Kong launches on Nintendo Switch.
Oh, I thought it was going to be a holiday release.
Pre-orders begin today.
But still, end of Switch life cycle, it definitely seems it's in line with what I'd expect to kind of finish things up.
Save the prince and the world.
Okay, Prince of Persia. The Lost Crown.
Sets off to save the Prince
of Persia. I heard a little bit about this, but I didn't watch really any gameplay.
Tapping into the roots of the Prince of Persia series, this game features 2D side-scrolling action-adventure gameplay. Dash through breathtaking environments.
I've never played a 2D Prince of Persia.
Don't linger too long.
I know there was one years ago.
Harness sword and bow techniques.
But I mean, I'd be interested in trying
as well
it out.
As time powers to best these hostile.
I just love the Sands of Time. Like, I just know it in 3D
Sargon
pretty much.
Stronger and learn new abilities that expand his arsenal. Equip amulets to further boost your abilities, among other perks. The number of amulets you can equip is limited, though, so choose wisely.
Always like that.
Use
some
everything at your
customization there.
This harsh world and defeat the mythical beasts.
It looks pretty cool. I'd be interested
get
in checking
ready to
it out.
Save the prince and discover the mysteries of Malkath. When Prince of Persia, The Lost Crown, launches
January.
On the Switch system, January 18th.
Wonder what the price point
the
is going to be for that.
An outfit by pre-ordering the game from Nintendo eShop.
Okay, pretty light announcement so far.
These games will help you chase your passions. Rev up for true arcade racing.
I love arcade racers.
Speed through stunning environments, each with its own dynamic art style.
Man,
while overtaking
I need to start playing some more arcade racers. I like them a lot.
Unlock vehicles,
I don't play them as much as I,
more.
You know, should.
You can also upgrade your vehicle.
Now, an exciting announcement for me would be a remake or
itching for
remaster of Cruisin' USA, Cruisin' World, Cruisin' Exotica. Those were my games back on the N64.
Go full throttle in Horizon Chase 2, launching on Nintendo Switch later today.
Oh, I might have to check that out.
Warm up for musical mayhem in this rhythm-based adventure. Time your button presses with the music.
Come on, you got to mix like a pretty exciting announcement in here. I mean, I like me a rhythm game, but that's not what I came here for.
Up to four friends can battle it out in versus modes or jam together in local or online play.
These are the type of games that, like, if they were on Game Pass or some kind of service like that, or Nintendo had it offered with the expansion pass, I would check it out. That's like really the only way to do that.
Anya Forger has a new assignment from school. Creating a photo diary.
Never heard of this game.
On weekdays, you'll head to class, then enjoy family time in the evenings. On days off, you can visit all sorts of exciting places, like the beach or an art museum.
That's
fun.
In
search of subjects to photograph. How will you spend your time with friends and family? And what kind of photo diary will you help Anya make?
When your family's not
Spy
enough,
Anya,
go
Operation
ahead and play this
Memories
game.
Launches on Nintendo Switch next year.
Okay.
Mario's first RPG.
Okay, they're
returns.
Touching upon this. Okay, we know it's coming.
The Super Mario RPG game is back.
We're gonna get some more
graphics.
Footage, but
Let's
it's like.
Let's go over some new and returning gameplay features. Time your button presses with action commands to increase.
I guess I should pay attention to this since I plan on playing this.
When you time your attacks perfectly, you can now damage all enemies at once.
Oh, that's new. Well, that's
Every
cool.
Every successful action command will fill this gauge. When it's full, you can unleash the three-character triple move.
Whoa.
Depending on your current party, the move will change. So
oh, that's cool.
Different combos.
I like that. I like the idea of them adding kind of new elements.
During
I just hope it doesn't make it too easy
or
ruin the original feel.
After clearing the game, you can fight some of them again.
Oh. It's like a boss rush.
Powered up bosses aren't gonna be easy.
Oh, that's cool. I like that. It reminds me of like Ocarina of Time 3D
Set
with all the extra stuff they added.
Mario and friends. When Super Mario RPG
All right. Okay, I'm a little bit more excited for this. I mean, I've never played it, so now I'm even more excited to play it. Definitely gonna have to get the physical copy though.
Look alive. We're almost there.
The The Nintendo DS game, Trace Memory, returns on the Nintendo Switch system as another code to memories. One day, a young girl named Ashley receives a letter from the father she thought had passed away. Seeking answers, she sets off for the solitary Blood Edward Island in search of him. Once there, Ashley encounters puzzles and obstacles that hinder her investigation.
So kind of like a mystery puzzle game. Whoa.
Can you see me?
She also meets a mysterious boy. What truths await Ashley in this place?
And no matter how hard
seems
I try,
interesting.
I can't remember Dad's face. Who are you?
The sequel, Another Code R, Journey into Lost Memories, previously unreleased in North America, is also included.
Oh, wow.
So this is like Juliet, huh?
Play both games to experience the full story. Unravel both adventures, fully enhanced for Nintendo Switch, when Another Code, Recollection, launches January 19th.
Okay.
Pre-orders begin
today.
I'm
sure fans of that series are going to be excited over that one, especially them remastering the previous game.
Another Code Recollection includes two games, the Nintendo DS game Trace Memory and its Wii sequel, which was never released in North America. Both games are fully enhanced on Nintendo Switch.
That's cool.
Please look forward to playing them early next year.
I'll have to look into that a little
next,
bit.
Please take a look at this.
Okay, what are we getting? Oh, is this the Peach game? Let's go. This is probably going to be the Peach game. We're going to see more than 2 seconds.
A loyal toad presented a flyer advertising a show at the Sparkle Theater.
Definitely
Princess
a Peach game.
Peach and some toads went to go see it. But then...
Uh-oh.
The Wicked Grape and the Sour Bunch suddenly made their grand entrance and took center stage. Now, it's up to Peach and the
twink?
Theater's guardian Stella to
come on, just make it
day.
Twink.
This perfect performance has become a terrible tragedy.
That's kind of cool, actually.
Luckily, Peach can use the power of Stella's ribbon to face off against the Sour Bunch. The ribbon alone won't always cut it, though. So let's do this. Whoa, Peach transformed into Sword Fighter Peach.
Oh, that kind of looked like a Smash entrance.
Fantastic show-stopping abilities. Bend
okay.
off the Sour Bunch with sensational
this
sword
game
play.
Actually is looking like it's going to be kind of good.
Can Peach save this performance?
And I'm sure there's going to be other power-ups too.
There are more stolen shows to save. Valuable artifacts from this museum have gone missing. Become Detective Peach, investigate clues, and track down.
This is giving me like Barbie vibes, where they kind of put Barbie in all these different situations, being a secret agent, explorer,
patissier Peach,
cook,
and save it from a sugar crash.
But I like it. I feel like that's like almost
the
a direction to go with
got
Peach.
Their hands on this martial arts school. Become Kung Fu Peach and take it back from these foul beings.
Yeah, this looks like it's gonna be cool. Like a mix of like action, puzzle, mystery,
Many
I guess.
Many other transformations are just behind the curtain. The stage.
Yeah, my wife's
set.
Gonna be excited for this one. I am too. It looks like it's gonna be good.
Princess Peach, showtime. Makes
okay.
its debut on Nintendo Switch
March
22nd.
I guess they said winter. They didn't just say holiday, so that's kind of where we're getting all this.
That was a new look at Princess Peach Showtime.
Well, I'm glad we got to see some of it for
once. In Peach's latest adventure, the gameplay changes depending on her transformations. It looks like there are more transformations beyond the ones we showed today, so please stay tuned. Let's continue with some more headlines.
All right.
A new saga begins. A multi-layered RPG full of rich stories awaits in
I've never
Saga
played these
Beyond.
Games, but it's Square Enix.
There are six
probably relatively decent.
From. a young man who fights with sentient puppets. A witch disguised as a schoolgirl to mask her identity.
Of course.
A crime-fighting duo chasing down a mysterious organization. A songstress mech who lost her voice and body.
This, like, Octopath?
And the King of Darkness.
It's all these different stories.
Reawakened. Select a hero, then follow their journey through 17 interconnected worlds as they strive to achieve their goals. How the story unfolds
also kind of gives me
hands. The choices you
live
make
alive,
can unlock
or
different paths.
Live alive, whatever, however you say it.
In the saga franchise.
But I guess it's been
fighting
a series.
Timeline battles, turn-based
I'd be interested
combat
in
which
trying
turn
that.
Order is crucial to victory. Use special techniques to control the order of actions, or activate team combos to swing the tide of battle in your favor.
Combat looks interesting.
Saga Emerald Beyond launches on Nintendo Switch next year.
I have to look a little bit more into that.
The Legendary Raider returns.
Like a remaster.
The first three Tomb Raider games, all with upgraded visuals, are venturing onto Nintendo Switch in one daring collection. As the fearless archaeologist,
I feel like upgraded
Croft,
visuals is a stretch. It almost looks like a coat of paint.
Against deadly
Not bad,
foes
though.
And even deadlier legends. Climb, backflip, and swan dive through perilous quests spanning different countries.
I mean, it would be cool to just have the option to play these
way,
old games, though.
You'll solve puzzles to uncover treasures of the ancient world.
I like
and
the new
unravel
ones.
Mysteries lost to the ravages of time. This faithfully remastered trilogy comes with all of the expansions and secret levels for each game.
Well, that's
you
cool.
You can also toggle between the original polygon look and the upgraded visuals at any time.
That's cool.
Tomb Raider 1 through 3 remastered.
I always like you when they give you or like it when they
launches
give you that
on the
option.
Nintendo Switch system February 14th. Pre-orders begin today. On
I've
Nintendo
only ever played
eShop.
Those old Tomb Raider games with like I feel like a demo on the Dreamcast. Is the only
brilliance.
Time I've ever played one of those.
Every great detective starts their day.
Graphics still look
this
like there's something
Rime
to be desired,
City,
but
where humans and
it's
Pokemon
Detective
coexist.
Pikachu.
The detective duo of Pikachu and his partner Tim investigate various cases
as they look like characters from
Harry, Tim's missing father.
Dreamlight.
Tim interviews
what is it,
people.
Dreamlight Valley.
Pikachu interviews Pokemon, and they find the truth together. They'll also rely on other Pokemon to broaden the scope of their investigations.
I've never really played the Detective Pikachu
Follow
games,
Sense
but I did watch the movie.
Smash rocks with Darmanitan. And
it looks like it would be fun.
Peer through walls with Luxray.
It's not really my thing, though.
Can Tim and Pikachu solve all the mysteries and find Harry? Find out
I don't
when
know.
Detective Pikachu returns.
Yeah, I guess find
Launches
out when
Nintendo
it comes
Switch,
out.
October 6th.
Okay.
Pre-orders
it's like
are
a holiday game.
On Nintendo eShop. This game's a real
Oh my
toot.
Gosh. Oh my gosh, they're bringing Why is
Raise
this in a direct?
For the quirky rhythm game, Trombone Champ. Play the notes in time.
I probably will end up playing this cuz it's just
but
ridiculous.
How you play that horn is up to you.
I can't believe this is in the direct.
You can use gyro controls to adjust the pitch.
That's kind of cool.
Or the IR motion camera on the right Joy-Con controller.
This is just
The controls are pretty unique.
Yeah, the game's
Mastering
unique.
Every control scheme won't be a walk in the park. Honk your way through nearly 50 songs spanning various genres, from classical to electronica and everything in between. Plus,
this looks like something out of a fever dream.
Band together in
but
local
I probably
multiplayer.
Will try it.
Trombone Champ.
Later today.
Switch,
oh no, I shouldn't
today.
Have said that then. Oh my.
Battle your way to victory in these Nintendo Switch games.
Okay.
10 teams of 3 will duke it out for survival in this online battle royale brawler.
League of Legends
Knock
clone.
Your opponent's health down to zero
battle crush.
And deliver a finishing blow. or shove them off the collapsing terrain to win.
Oh man. So far,
inspired by a different mythology.
The direct is lacking for me. I know there's still some time left and they have to get through these fluff announcements, but it doesn't seem like the pacing's great. You need to throw something pretty exciting.
Your mercenaries to fame and fortune in this open world tactical RPG.
Come on.
Take up various contracts, from protecting townsfolk from thieves to vanquishing the land's most notorious figures. Before battle, equip your mercenaries with the best gear and skills to claim victory and live to see.
I get these announcements, and they seem like decent games, fun games. But you gotta throw like a show, a little showstopper, like near the beginning, near the middle, near the end, or even just beginning and end, middle and end, like something.
Run and gun in this reimagining of the beloved NES classic, Contra. Blast
okay,
explosive
that's cool.
Stages with a devastating arsenal of weapons to crush.
Contra's always fun. I always wanted to play more of the
Spring
games.
Spring into action with easy pickup and play controls and a variety of difficulty options. This reimagining from Konami and WayForward features new weapons, enemies.
Yeah, I'm probably gonna have to check this one out.
Super attacks and a four-player co-op mode.
Let's
Contra, go! Operation Galuga storms onto the Nintendo Switch system early next year.
Okay, no date, but hopefully soon
Liberate
enough.
Your kingdom. Reclaim your destiny.
Okay.
'Tis a grievous tale which speaks of Fevrith, one of stolen destiny, stolen minds, and stolen nations.
Square Enix?
Yet as the world stands consumed by immense evil, a fallen prince shall rise again, ring
now,
of legend lighting his path.
That is the Ring of the Unicorn, ancestral treasure of Cornia's royal lineage. Legend speaks of your ancestors wielding it to purify evil. Yet the answer is clear as day now. The path before us
the
is
art style is neat.
It
reminds me of those, like,
walk it.
2D
walk it, will,
Sega Dreamcast fighters.
Freely traverse an expansive
world. It
kind
of switches in and out.
Gather new allies, forge your bonds, and lead the liberation to glorious victory. Cultivate a grand army with over 60 unique characters, from humans and elves to massive beasts and heavenly
angels. Okay, getting a little more interested in this.
Today marks our first foray into the mists of despair which hang heavy over our home. It may take days, months, or even years. But I shall see the duties of my bloodline fulfilled.
Atlas and Vanillaware present the rebirth of tactical fantasy RPGs. Unicorn Overlord.
Oh, okay. I was like wondering, I'm like, is this something? Is this a game I should know? But no, that seems to be a new game. Looks interesting. Okay, here we go. Getting some Luigi's Mansion 2. Right after I started the third one. Let's go. I'm excited for this because I've never played through it, and it's going to be nice to play it on the Switch.
Luigi's Mansion 2 HD.
They're just going to call it HD. That's a little
Welcome
bit lame.
Evershade Valley, a place
call
that's
it like Deluxe
teeming with the supernatural.
Remastered.
Luigi, our faint of heart hero, was sent here to check it out. Time for some mansion mayhem. No spooky adventure is complete without this vacuum-like device, the Poltergust.
Oh yeah.
Use it to light up dark areas.
I love Luigi's Mansion. I mean, I feel like it doesn't get enough credit.
Interact with the
it's a super unique game.
It's a handy tool for your paranormal escapades.
Yeah, I'm definitely excited to play this.
Plus, when you spot a ghost, pop! You can stun them with the strobe ball, then vacuum them up. You can even grab multiple ghosts at once.
Whoa!
In this game, you'll find Ghosts Haunting, a former plant research lab.
Okay.
A broken down clock factory that's full of sand. A mine
yes,
covered in
sand.
Ice and snow, and even more places.
Oh, I'm excited for the ice level.
These troublemakers will use every trick in the book to block your path. Can Luigi summon his courage and save
the day? I think the piano is really fitting for this.
Looking for other ghost hunters? Up to 4 players online can do some exercise across different multiplayer modes.
Okay, that's cool.
Luigi's Mansion 2 HD.
Okay, now when is it coming out?
To Nintendo Switch next summer.
Summer? Come on, you. This gotta be a Halloween title.
Next year.
We
have 2 announcements to share.
Okay.
First, please take a look at this video.
Come on, don't get me excited. What is it? Come on. Okay, question mark block?
It's a large question block.
Yes.
Actually, this question block currently appears on the roof of the previously announced Nintendo Gallery that's under construction in Uji City, Kyoto Prefecture.
Okay.
The official name of this gallery will be the Nintendo Museum. At the Nintendo Museum, a wide variety of Nintendo products from the company's history will be displayed.
That's
construction
cool.
is going well, and we plan to finish up by March 2024.
We'll that would be cool to visit.
Such as the opening date at another time. Please stay tuned. Next, we'd like to share some updates on upcoming amiibo figures. The Zelda and Ganondorf amiibo figures are releasing on November 3rd. And amiibo figures of Noah and Mio from the Xenoblade Chronicles 3 game will be released as a set on January 19th, 2024.
Okay, the Zelda ones look cool.
And finally, we have a new amiibo figure to announce. The DLC fighter from Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, Sora from Kingdom Hearts,
okay.
is on the way.
That's cool to have an amiibo
with
for that.
With the release of Sora, everyone is here from Super Smash Bros. Ultimate in amiibo form. Please look forward to its release next year.
Next year. Okay, I'll have to pick that one up.
That's all for today's amiibo announcements.
Oh.
Next, please take a look at this.
I thought they were going to say that was it for the Direct. I was going to say, no, no you don't. What is this? Oh! Oh! Here we go! This is what I called it! Let's go! What are you doing?
F-Zero game returns as a 99-player battle royale!
If this is limited, I'm gonna be so mad. But that's pretty cool. It's not what I was hoping for, but that's pretty cool. As long as they keep it around.
High-speed races, but be careful. Your power meter will
That's cool. That's cool.
Into pilots or guardrails. If it hits zero,
they need
out.
To do a 99, but with F-Zero GX, or just a remaster. But this is cool. This is a cool one to do for 99.
Feeling risky?
I'm excited to try this out.
Power meter for a temporary speed boost.
I never played the Super Nintendo one that often, but in this kind of format,
super sparks,
I'm into
which appear
it.
When machines collide, to boost up to a special
okay,
path called
okay.
the Skyway. It's your best chance at bypassing your rivals
Is
and
like
jumping
a...
into a higher position.
Yeah, it looks like a automatic path kind of thing,
complete
like a bullet bill
while you're
almost.
Racing to unlock cosmetic options for your machine.
And you're probably gonna have the option to pay for that too. Okay, but this is cool. Just tell me it comes out today so I can try it out.
99 players, one winner. It's time to race your way to first place.
Okay.
Because F-Zero 99 will be available exclusively for active Nintendo Switch Online members later today.
Let's go! Okay. We're gonna definitely try this out.
More than 30 years after its original release, F-Zero is back as a battle royale.
Okay.
This title also supports the Super NES controller
well,
available exclusively for Nintendo Switch Online members.
It's cool. It's you don't have to be an
we
expansion pass
give it a try
member for
and
that.
For first place. Okay, let's continue with some more headlines.
One little hero.
Okay, that was a cool announcement. Not GX, but it's
Welcome
cool.
to Bandle City.
I like the. I think that's one of the best ideas for a 99.
Fuzzy beings called Yordles.
All
After
right.
a party gets a little too wild, the portals holding the land together collapse and throw everything into chaos. It's up to you and your knitting magic to stitch Bandle City back together. journey across the land to gather materials and craft items and meals for the locals.
They're all hyped up with F-Zero, and then I'm like, what is this?
You can weave together new upgrades by unlocking more branches of the skill tree. Enchant your experience even further by embarking on quests and hosting festivals for the community. Can you save Bandle City? And what mysteries will you discover during your magical adventure? Bandle Tale, a League of Legends story,
2024.
Launches on Nintendo Switch next year.
Okay.
Wait, did you hear that? Join best friends, Nunu and Willem, on a journey across Nunu the frozen Willem. Wilds of the Freljord. Jump, climb, and sled your way through a beautiful yet treacherous land, where every step taken,
I do. I always like me a winter
will bring you closer to
game.
The truth about these friends and their past. Song of Nunu, a League of Legends story, launches on the Nintendo Switch.
See, I'm not a big League of Legends person, but it does look like a pretty cool game.
Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop. Let's move into four nations.
Okay, here we go.
A trip with these chumps doesn't feel like a prize.
I hope this is good. I like that they're bringing the motion controls back, because I love the one on the Wii.
This tropical resort contains tons of micro games that'll get your
That will be me.
Moving. In each micro game, you'll get into a specific pose called a form.
Okay, they're bringing forms back.
Copy the form shown, then perform the correct
You know what?
Action,
I'm good with it. They don't if it's not broke, don't fix it. Oh well.
The micro games
bringing that sensor
one
into
after
this.
Another, so look alive.
I hope the motion controls translate well. I know, like,
plus, up to
going from the Wiimote to the Joy-Cons.
Mode.
And I did like the multiplayer on
Reach
the Wii
the goal
game.
Without getting caught by Medusa.
Freeze.
Or settle the score in an arena to be the last one posing.
Okay, that's
With
cool.
With over 200 lightning-fast micro-games and multiplayer modes aplenty. Everyone's in for a wacky time. WarioWare Move It launches on the Nintendo
November 3rd. Okay. Okay. I was hoping it was this winter. I mean, I was looking forward to this one.
A heroic tale will soon unfold.
Okay, what's this?
Lead an army of over 100 heroes into battle and put an end to an empire's invasion. Meet Noah, a humble villager.
Noah, with a W.
Zane, an officer from the Empire. And Marissa, a forest guardian. These three band together to fight for a common goal. On their journey, they'll meet a variety of heroes who can join their
The
cause.
Shark.
This is your home base, known as the Headquarters. As allies
okay.
join you, additional facilities will become available.
I always
You'll
like that dynamic.
Crops, open shops, and more.
Or that kind
Each hero
of feature.
You encounter has their own backstory and motivation. They may not always get along at first, but these conflicts may strengthen the bonds between your heroes.
Okay.
Trust, betrayal, justice.
And I feel like there's a lot of these type of games in this direct.
Tale will begin.
But I mean, I'm here for it. I like this.
On Nintendo Switch, April 23rd.
Oh, okay. Not too long.
Participate in some pixel perfect play.
Pixel perfect.
Next stop, Octopia. Travel to a charming parallel world in this paid DLC for Eastward. Help Sam and John
okay, I've
turn
never
the
played
pages
Eastward.
Of a new chapter as they adjust to country life.
Is it like
in
a Stardew Valley
village.
Type of game?
Tend to livestock. Whip up culinary delights for your neighbors. And restore buildings to help the village thrive. And if you're new to Eastward, don't worry. You can access the DLC.
It definitely gives me Stardew Valley vibes.
Eastward, Octopia.
It could be
ventures
a really
onto
good
Nintendo
game.
Switch this holiday.
Okay.
Get back into the groove.
Oh man, a lot of these like strategic
In this
fighters.
Sequel to War Groove. Charge across three tactical campaigns with valiant factions, including a new mousefolk faction, the Fari. Plus, you can now supercharge.
I'm getting fatigued from these games. Like I need something. F-Zero was like the one announcement that kind of changed it up, and I was like, oh, okay, I'm here for that. And now it's like, where's the Donkey Kong? Where's that like different exciting announcement? Yes, F-Zero was a good announcement, but it was like one of those supplement ones you do throughout the direct to keep the pacing okay. It's not one of the showstoppers yet, in my opinion.
Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop.
Okay, what now?
Dive and catch fish by day.
Yes.
Then serve them as sushi by night and the aquatic adventure, Dave the Diver.
Dave the Diver.
Use the fish you've caught to concoct recipes and create the day's menu. Then tend to the clamoring customers at your sushi restaurant. Explore an ever-changing underwater world to find the best ingredients and strive to exceed
culinary
expectations.
Okay, it seems like one of those like weird games that I feel like I could either not like at all or be one of my favorite games. Kind of like how Catherine was for me.
Later today.
Okay, later today.
The final wave.
Oh, let's go.
Here's a
final
wave.
Let's see.
The final wave of the Mario Kart 8 Deluxe Booster Course.
Okay, I think that was
DLC.
Is that from the 3DS?
Daisy Circuit.
More okay.
Characters are also being added in
Ooh,
wave six.
Let's see, Diddy Kong. Let's go.
Diddy Kong.
We had to get Diddy Kong. Funky Kong. Let's go. That was the one I wanted the most.
And from the Mario Kart Tour game.
Okay, Pauline. Okay, Pauline should have been in 8 to begin with. So I'm not. I don't even care if she's from Tour. I'm
and
glad
also,
they brought her in here.
Peachette.
Now that's lame. Like, okay, Peachette, but like, come Wave on, that's one of those cop-out ones. It's Peach, but looks a little
DLC
different.
For the Mario Kart
okay, Wave 6.
Drives onto Nintendo
this
Switch
holiday,
this
okay.
Holiday.
Wish we had a date,
Nintendo Switch Online
but
Plus expansion
that's fine.
Can enjoy this DLC at no additional
we'll
cost.
See it. I think last time we got a like a holiday wave, it was in December, so. Wonder if it's gonna be the same.
Something new is among
like,
us.
What is this? I know it's Among Us, but like, is it DLC? Like, that's not good. I mean, I've never played Among Us. I, like, know what it's about. So, I wouldn't mind giving it a try. So, maybe if this DLC looks pretty cool. A new map. Heating. The fungal.
This new map for Among Us is free and launches this October.
Okay, well that's cool. It's free at least.
What did you think?
Eh.
Thanks for sticking with us this far.
One more announcement.
Next up, we'd like to recap some of the previously announced Nintendo titles you can look forward to playing from September onwards. Let's take a look.
Here we go, another recap. Yeah. Physical version, that's what I have pre-ordered. Yes, Super Mario Wonder, I am excited for that. I keep using that same clip. Alright, yep. Next wave. More DLC. Mario vs. Donkey Kong. Princess Peach, I'm excited for that. Luigi's Mansion... like summer next year, like
we hope you're looking forward to
that. Seems
titles.
Filler like crazy.
This next video will be our last announcement.
Of course,
please take a look.
Come on, you gotta bring this direct back with this. Wait, no, Let's go! Oh my gosh! Let's go! Wait! Yes! Let's go! Oh, I was actually gonna start the playthrough on the GameCube. It looks so good! It looks so good! Oh, come on! Oh, I can't wait! Oh my gosh! Oh, it's beautiful! Oh my gosh, I am playing this day one! Let's go! Okay, I was hoping for a GameCube remaster that I was excited for. And I was expecting F-Zero, but I will take this all day. Oh my gosh, I didn't even say this was one I wanted because I just didn't think we were getting it. Paper Mario and the Thousand Year Door, let's go. I can't wait. Ooh, I wonder if they're gonna add anything new like they did with Super Mario RPG.
Look at it!
Oh my gosh, it looks so clean. I knew it would clean up well in HD, but like, this is even better than I thought. This is what people want for like, next gen or like, current gen Paper Mario games. And I hope they see, from hopefully this doing well, that they gotta go back to this like, style of gameplay. Yes! When's it coming out? You better say this year. Come on. There's Peach! Oh, the AI. Oh, man. Yeah. 2024. Dang it! I was hoping this would be this year.
I guess they have Thousand Year Door, Super Mario RPG. Originally released on Nintendo GameCube, will return with enhanced graphics. Whether you played the original or have yet to play it, we hope you look forward to experiencing this adventure in a paper world starring Mario and friends.
Yes.
That's all for today's
Okay.
Thank you for
watching. For me, that made this direct, like, okay. Like, I was thinking it was bad for a while, but, like, that relatively saved it for me. Okay, so that was the September 14th, 2023 Nintendo Direct. And relatively disappointing most of the time. We got that F-Zero 99 announcement, and that was pretty cool. And they kind of saved it at the end with Paper Mario and the Thousand Year Door. Let's go! Oh my gosh, I am so excited for that. Like, they could have just announced that game and this direct would have been, like, at least a B for me. So I'm gonna give this direct a B. It was gonna be a C or a D before that last announcement. But outside of those two announcements, it was pretty much stuff we already knew about, other, like, than some new, like, fantasy RPG kind of stuff, tactic games. Which, you know, those are good. I like those here and there. But overall, the direct was okay and then good because of the last announcement. I hope you enjoyed the video. Tell me what you thought about the direct, what announcements you're excited for, and what you plan on playing, and what you want me to play. And until then, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!